Welcome back to the World Esports Game. That's a nice badge you got on.
Pretty pride colors.
Well, you need it, obviously, to get into the exclusive places that you get into, right?
I mean, I've actually forgotten this to the hotel a couple of days, and I just walk around. No one's asked anything.
That I have been able to do that for a bit, but I got a little bit scared by the riot guys on the door and decided I would get a new one. I didn't think it would be a very good idea. Obviously, enough of like what we're doing. It is map number two, Nuke. Yep. Virtus Pro.
Home turf.
Yeah.
Home turf.
Do you see, are there any like win conditions, anything you can see that Space Soldiers can actually take this map and take it to three?
Well, it's hard to see those, considering the fact that VP has shown extreme strength on Nuke. And like, I didn't get to see the game. I heard that Space Soldiers had one heck of a CT side on Nuke against iGame. But then again, iGame, very different beast from VP, and I don't even know their pedigree on Nuke either. So I think it's very tough to see them win.
Well, I think, we saw VP versus Envy, right? And they were pretty consistent on that. So
yep, not too
I think
shabby.
It was only really Apex like having a couple of rounds that had any problems with their CT side whatsoever.
Yeah, I mean, there was a couple of rounds where Envy managed to execute towards upper bomb site, one with pistols and one with full weaponry, where they managed to kind of sandwich that defense and make it uncomfortable for Virtus Pro. But other than that, Snax is so good on yard. For example, Aneo compliments helping him from heaven and from hell with an op. And then Snax just lurking around the smokes and just getting so many kills.
Just doing Snax things
when the T's are trying to take over yard, which is, you know, one of the go-to plans here on new T side. You kind of have to try to at least make it seem like you're taking over yard. And when you do that, Snax is going to be heck of a problem.
I think also yesterday I quite enjoyed Pasha over towards ramp. Just doing the job very consistently. I like watching Magisk over on that position as well. Like very, very good over towards
this. Is also the home turf of Taz. Been through our times. He's so good on Nuke usually.
Yeah, he was the star in that game versus Envy. Exactly. Absolutely brilliant. I think he was playing by Hot, if I'm correct.
Yeah, he plays upper. Almost, I think, pretty much always done that for the last 15 years.
Well, I suppose he's got pretty good at it in that amount of time.
Yeah, I mean, you should be able to find your comfort zone in that time. But it appears the VP is going to get to start on city side. So definitely not going to be easy for Space Soldiers. Remember, Space Soldiers won both pistol rounds on Kabul, and they ended up with 8 rounds.
Yeah, well, and the pistol round was the only round they won on that T side. So.
Okay, let's look at this now. Space Soldiers are opting to go for two sets of nades. They have Major with a Technon armor as well. Seems like they are going in towards lobby and ramp right now.
Just going to try and get up close and personal to Pasha. Doing his best just to try and fade away, but it doesn't look like it's going to happen. Major will start things off with the first kill, and now we're going to see them drop towards that B site, but quick rotations will allow Neo to get himself a kill straight back in. They do, of course, have a kit ready for this B site, and they're just going to fade away, try and keep things easy. Major getting very close, but he's actually going to lose his life to Bialy. Bomb will go down within the smoke, and Zontara's again back to actually a 3v2, 3v1 even, as Paz gets another one, and now it's just Snax. Doesn't have himself the kit. There is a kit somewhere on the map, but well, Zontara's just going to take his head clean off. And Space Soldiers with another pistol.
Yeah, that's 3 out of 3 so far for Space Soldiers in this best of 3, and that's the kind of start they definitely need here on Nuke. And that was them just going over on ramp. Major as the raid boss, being the first guy in, getting the initial kill onto Pasha. He might have slightly overextended going to the vents, trying to go into the back halls. I think he should have just maybe stayed in the vents and, you know, just play the afterplan from there. But eventually, his teammates did clean it up, and they do pick it up. And as we can see from VP side, they've done some investments here. There's 3 deagles, a CZ, and a scout in play.
And this time, Space Soldiers going to go with a few rifles.
No upper rush. Kind of disappointed here.
Not going to go for a hugely risky buy. Snax is going to be naded down to just 17 HP, so we'll have to fade away. Of course, with that deagle repositioning, just going to hold an angle and try and get that one ball, which this weapon is so well known for. Scout outside on Neo hasn't really been able to spot anything too much. May have got the tag onto Zontaris, who is now down to 39 HP. And I like this from Snax. He's going to try and use the door.
Yep. Definitely. They're not taking their time. They have the utility to go lower bomb side. They can smoke off left or right side, Molotov the other side, on towards ramp, and then get the bomb plant.
Taz will be able to take down one of those AKs. Wonder if he's actually going to be able to retrieve it. Does have himself armor as well, which, well, that could be a bit of a game changer. I don't think he's really got the possibility, and actually Neo is going to fall in the meantime. The SMG's doing quite a lot of work in this round. In fact, Viali is going to go pushing towards Antares, who is the one defending the AK. Taz able to take down a second, but much better this time from Space Soldiers, and they're not going to be able to retrieve one of the AKs.
Yep, very traditional anti-eco, going yard slowly, just trying to feel out what the Cs are doing. VPU not able to really utilize that scout from Neo at all. Snacks also being in secret, getting tagged down to very low HP very initially. That Space Soldiers just taking over the lower tunnels there towards the lower bomb site, and then eventually with three alive, winning that round.
Snack's not going for any armor in the last, means he is actually going to buy another Deagle into this round. Apart from that, we've got one P250 on the board and absolutely nothing else on the Virtus Pro side. Major, well, he's looking to just have a field day at this point. He's got his MAC-10. He's doing quite well with it so far. Actually had it in a couple of buy rounds versus Envy and still managed to pull off quite a bit of damage, so definitely someone who enjoys this weapon. Neo will be the first of all. Not really expecting too much, but Snacks is in a decent position to catch one. Nice shot onto Zantares. Actually going to be a dink coming in onto Paz as well. They do have to be a little bit careful here, Space Soldiers. Don't really want to lose too much in this round. Major is going to give them back the man advantage once again. They are just bringing that AK along with them. Don't want any opportunity for someone on Virtus Pro to grab that.
Yep. Definitely try to avoid that and make sure Major manages to pick it up eventually if he stays alive. Snacks contemplating on the idea of going down ladder. It's going to come down to timing for him if he manages to get down there. It's going to be all down to Snacks now. Deagle in hand. Maneuvering around here, going towards hell.
Still an AK on the floor somewhere. Imagine it's probably in the worst possible position to him to try and get.
Yeah, lower bombs at somewhere, so. Yeah, there we go. It's already picked up.
And now, well, just going to wait for the exit. Try and find someone along the way. Despy, only with an SMG, so he's going to be the furthest forward, just clearing out angles. Don't want to risk an AK. Will actually lose his life. UMP, well, can actually be utilized, and any more kills from Snacks here is more than he should get, and well, they are going to finish him off. So, good work in the end from Space Soldiers. They keep all their weapons in play.
Yep.
And, well, now we go into the buy round.
Yeah, Major making its way down secret, and basically the rest of Space Soldiers taking over a ramp, and then eventually making their way downstairs to the lower bomb site. And then, again, if you have three surviving from them, so at least that's some money being saved going far forward. And as we can see, VP is not going to be able to get any ops in here in the first weapon round with the second round investment.
Do have a decent amount of utility, though.
Yep.
Especially considering only one kit, fourth though. Round by one kit onto Taz. Boost will be put into place. Normally good for at least one kill, but then coming around the corner, it is very difficult to defend that position without any other support. See, Neo is playing a position where he could get back there, but definitely not going to be the easiest case scenario. Smokes going to be laid down outside. As you said previously, this can just be used for the illusion of pushing out, but we are actually going to see Major going along. Paz will be spotted for it by Snacks, and don't think there's really anything he can do about these players crossing over.
Yeah, bomb is down in lobby, though, so that might be an idea for us that it could still be like an upper split coming in. People try to get into the vents and then creep up from them. And basically coming through squeaky and hot. And now Fall Flush comes in and Zantares gets that first kill into Pasha. This does pass on to Snacks.
Yeah, no, that really shouldn't have happened. That position is very, very strong for getting the first player running around the corner. Well, Zantares was just too good. It will be the trade eventually, but still the man advantage sat with Space Soldiers. If they can get themselves a 5-0 start on Nuke, well, that could be a completely different story. However, Neo is actually going to drop one and the bomb.
Yeah, low HP on Paz, and now Despy as well, even though he does get a kill on the Taz. So, still all to do for here for Bialy and Neo. The bomb is down too, so.
Oh, is he going to hear them? He's definitely going to hear them. Doesn't manage to connect the first shots. Flashbang comes in and Paz peeks while it pops. Nothing Neo can do in that situation. Now Bialy, well, the one thing on his side is the time. 14 seconds left. Doesn't manage to connect the spray onto Major. And it will be a fourth round in a row now for Space Soldiers. Similar start to the previous map.
Yeah. Solid job from Xantharis getting that pick on ramp. I mean, either he expected there to be boost up there, or he was so up close somewhere in radio that he heard them boost up there. Those are two options, basically. Well, he got the first kill, and then Paz also converting for another one, 5-on-3. Neo then for the bit of a flank from ramp. That's where the bomb drop in lobby, but solid job again from Space Soldiers to be able to pick up that bomb once again with a bit of teamwork there. With the Paul Flash coming in, taking out Neo. Pialino 103 in the end. And again, it's going to be outside smokes coming in here for Space Soldiers. About the bomb down again towards lobby, so just two guys committing their way towards secret.
Snacks. First of all, managed to do a little bit of damage, but not anything too crazy. And it is looking like this outer push is something Space Soldiers quite enjoy. It's going to be taking this battle again, well, especially in these anti-eco rounds, they just take it straight down and just try and push around. Obviously taking a lot of map control. Bomb yet to move as of yet. Oh. Peeking against this scout is a little bit risky, though. Don't really know why they're still doing it. Neo may be able to take a couple major eventually trades, and they will take him down and win the round.
Yep. Again, outside smokes from Space Soldiers, sending three up there. Despy on top of the roof.
Ooh, double up.
Then he had to go through towards Secret. And yeah, just slowly trying to gain map control and making sure they're playing together, playing off of each other. In case one of you falls, you'll have a teammate to trade the kill straight from the get-go. And they do survive with four alive, so that's a very solid anti-eco. And as he pointed out, VP has gone for double offs, but it's going to be an up rush coming in.
This could be the worst case scenario. Taz, you've got a hell of a lot to do, but he's got support from Bialy. First kill goes, but Xantharis with two entries onto the site leaves it into a 3v3. Taz is going to maneuver himself between the silos, but he's actually going to get his life lost to Major. Snacks with one back and actually spraying through the smoke. Manages to catch Despy quite heavily down to 41 HP. Pasha as well rotating in will drop the bomb. And now Despy is left alone. Taz really buying a lot of time there for his team to rotate in. But it's still Despy versus two. Now, he had a decent start to the map, was one of the players that actually got them a couple of rounds after those initial five. Normally, with that AWP, will manage to retrieve the bomb. Obviously, still got Pasha in upper, and the second he tries to plant this bomb, it should be lights out. Got 55 seconds to play with, though. Does not have to rush at all. But the big problem is Snacks. It's just going to be sneaking around behind him. Any noise made, and well, Snacks is just going to finish him off. Actually trying to get towards Pasha here. This could work quite nicely. He's managed to do it very, very silently, but Pasha catches him in the end.
Yeah, he does. And that was just Despy basically trying to isolate into two individual one-on-ones. Mm. That's the whole idea he was there having there. And yeah, I mean, that upper rush pretty much was the best possibility they had against double ops. Obviously not knowing there was double ops, but I still do like the idea. And I think, you know, solid job from Taz, for example, just stay alive as long as he did, you know, getting a couple kills there along the lines. And then obviously that Snacks in main, he gets the guy that jumps in through the smoke into main. That creates the 2-on-2. So very close again. Space Soldiers managing to get that 5-0 lead. Is it going to be a similar story as Pasha starts off with two great kills here?
Yeah, making things very difficult. I don't see the T's pushing this anymore. It just doesn't really seem worth it. Actually going to go for the pop flash, but I think that was just trying to get them out of position. Now, the T's with a two-man disadvantage. Obviously, the economy on VP is not that great. You see Neo actually pulling in a mag 7. We'll be playing. Actually, he's outside at the moment. I think he was just using the stairs of secret as his sort of little mag 7 hidey hole, Bialy. He's going to fall over towards Hut. We'll give them a way back into this round. Snack's going to try and slow them down, but he doesn't actually decide to throw the Molotov. Taz coming in from upper as well as Xantharis. Oh, we know that he can be ready, and they're actually going to double molly him back, leaving them into a 3v4 with the bomb down. Time's starting to tick away, but they are running out, or run out pretty much, a utility. They've only got one flashbang to play with. Xantharis, a lot of damage through the smoke, but it's actually Paz to find the kills. Xantharis doing a lot of damage at this point, and he even finish off Pasha as well. One tap in the end. And Space Soldier straight back into a winning streak.
In a 3-on-5 of all things as well. Basically, Engine getting that kill, opening a squeaky door, getting the kill on Bialy, who was on top of Hut, and that's basically the upper defense being nullified. And they get the bomb down, and then Xantharis once again showing up strong. A couple of kills, a lot of damage on the third guy as well, in main through smokes. And there you have it. It's going to be VP in struggle with their economy. They've been reset here.
Six rounds already on the T side.
Yeah, very, very good from Space Soldiers. Definitely showing some early strength here on Nuke.
Starting to get a little bit worrying for Vedaspar. Well, I think it's getting past a little bit worrying. Taz will be able to, however, find the first kill of the round. Very aggressive from him. Doesn't have that many bullets to play with in Zantara's. Well, he's not even going to give him the chance to find anything more. Despi down to 1 HP, however, does mean that there's still a lower player that could very easily fall to these pistols. Although, actually, he does go down. That is going to be an AK into the hands of Bialy. Pasha is going to spot Engine as well through the door, manages to finish him off. Not like this, Space Soldiers. After such a good round, to throw one away like this would be horrific. Major down to 35 HP. Zantara is the only player with any real health on the other side of things. The second AK has been picked up. Neo will, however, fall to Zantara's, and they have managed to get themselves the B site. Smoke will go down to allow them to plant the bomb, and the Molotov smartly placed to deny any quick rotations that can come in. Decent positioning, however, from Bialy could be the linchpin in this round. Manages to find one. Only Zantara's left. He's got a lot to do, and Snacks is going to finish him off. Wonderful round from Virtus Pro, but Space Soldiers, well, they've thrown it away to pistols.
Yeah. They fall third in a moment where they were sitting on the driver's seat. Just pedal to the metal. Can't go forward, but instead, they're going to be losing that one there. Not really sure why Despi went for the outside catwalk there anymore. When you could tell VP was being, first of all, in a save situation and being very aggressive. So he still decided to go on outside catwalk. He had a CT there pushed up, goes down, and then kind of crumbles one by one from there on out.
And this has given a huge lifeline out of Virtus Pro. They could have been in a double eco situation going into the next round. So, yeah,
this is definitely, this could really change everything in terms of this first half, because I was going to say that it's very likely right now that Space Soldiers are going to be in the lead going into the halftime.
Mm. Yeah, cannot disagree with that. They were so very close, but yeah, they've handed economy back over to Virtus Pro. Three AKs picked up and off, been bought for Pasha. Major going to be caught. What? Snacks almost finishing him off. 22 HP. Pasha has found another one in the meantime. Bialy actually shoots a little bit too early, but he should get one. Second Major actually going to win the duel, even with 22 HP.
Nice patience there for Major.
And Despi as well jumping down. This should be the end of Tax, but... Tax? Snacks? It's Taz and Snacks combined.
That's their love child.
Oh, God. And you never pay tax. That's always the thing, isn't it?
Okay, then. Of course you do.
Of course, no. Engine is going to fall to Snacks. I'll get his name right this time. And that will be
slight like gap in the smoke there on yard. That's what had Major go down in HP so much. And Bialy doing a great job there in secret, buying a lot of time, getting that one kill. I feel like he should have had another one there, but Major with some dance moves gets the kill. But VP now sitting at three, and an eco coming in from Space Soldiers.
Yeah, well, that's what happens when you lose a round to flat pistols. Your economy takes a massive hit. Had to force everything into the last, and they're coming back with very, very little. Virtus Pro really handed a huge opportunity. Flashbang will come out. They do know that Pasha is going to have this AWP, but he's not going to miss that shot. Paz, he's going to fall to the Deagle as well. Pasha yet to take a single point of damage. It looks like he may just be able to farm up some kills here. Despi coming in, but lovely one dig. Neo quickly to trade, so not too much of a problem. Obviously, every kill will help them at this stage. Virtus Pro, not with a huge amount of money in the bank. Taz is going to lose his life as well. Back to a 2v3. Bialy should be ready. They do actually have the bomb. If they can get this kill on Bialy, that would be a plan. But actually, crossfire in play. Snacks will get both. And a fourth on the board for VP.
Yeah, the AWP is being retrieved by Neo as well. So at least they had three survived that, so a bit of bank being made here for VP. And back to buying for Space Soldiers. Still no op for them. It's going to be all AKs. I mean, AWP on T-side of Nuke. This is definitely the last resort, so they don't seem desperate enough to have to go there yet. I mean, they've had a solid T-side so far. The only dent has to be the fact they lost to that eco. And that's what's giving Virtus Pro a chance. And I'm not sure you want to give those kind of chances to a team like Virtus Pro.
Oh, definitely not. Definitely not.
Seems like an Opera Executor is coming in from Space Soldiers.
They're going to try the door thing again.
actually going to be the bomb dropped outside by Snacks. That's going to put a little bit of a dent in this plan. And Bialy, using the Tech 9, switching over to the AK, finds another as well. Triple Lovely. For him. And Zantara is now left. Well, this is a big problem. He knows that Snacks is somewhere outside, obviously. Well, actually, no, he's rotated all the way back in since he's got that kill.
This time, Bialy was ready for that squeaky door to open. This massive amount of damage. Dancing around of smoke. As Bialy is going to get that last kill on Xantaras as well. And a clean sweep for Virtus Pro.
And now the money time. Is...
And now they're swimming in cash right now. And it's going to be another save here. So save Space Soldiers. And it's all tied up. Again, a massive lead. Just gone.
On one round. Like, you can pin nearly all of them.
This could have been easily at 8-2 before a Virtus Pro could have bought. Unless they won that eco round.
Yeah, not good.
That's the consequence out of the fact that they lost that eco.
Pistols once again. Pasha is going to be ready and waiting to try and line up these players. They managed to take him down last time. Nade going to do so much damage already. Now he's just going to wait. They're actually going to throw it a second, but Zantaras does manage to get that kill. Pasha not really having too much luck at the moment. Neo is still there. We'll be tapping away. He's going to have to fall back in the end and give up a little bit of control, but he does have Snacks to support. And, well, what more do you need?
Yep. Snacks almost at 16k at this point already. Well, full buy for Space Soldiers again. AK-47s. All utility being bought as well. I think the most they've really had is through their outside smokes and then sending a couple secret, taking over a ramp, going over bomb side. So they definitely do have depth into their play box. Let's see what they do. They're just going to go dry on guard. Take a duel with Snacks, who's going to get the first major equalizes before Pasha gets his own.
Yeah, Pasha actually now moving over to playing the outside position. SP. Oh, almost giving a kill over to Pasha, and actually does. He's fallen back. The aggressive push will come out from Taz, and he falls in the meantime, giving them a lifeline. But Pasha's just lining them up and knocking them down. Pixelated angles. Wow. That was lovely from Pasha.
Yeah, I mean, that was him being moved from a ramp to autobomb to yard. That's Virtus Pro basically having a feel. You know, Space Soldiers has done a lot of work through yard, so let's send our opera there. To back Snacks up, and well, it did definitely work this time. As it happened, Space Soldiers, for some reason, decided to run in there totally dry. No smokes or anything. That's very interesting.
Oh, Pasha's just going to say thank you very much.
Questionable, I would say.
Engine will actually purchase up an AWP of his own. Glass Cannon, interested to see it come out on him. It is normally Despy with it in hand. Are they going to try and challenge outside? It is Snacks with another AWP this time. And, well, these AWPs have started to make things much more difficult for Space Soldiers to actually get any presence on the map.
Yeah, well, now they're in desperation mode as Engine has that AWP. And they've already lost one man in Paz. But they have gotten a lot of map control. This Major is very close to main right now. Could potentially set up for a bit of a upper split, but as I say that, Snacks with an op is just going to nullify Major.
Yeah, he tries to go a little bit further around, doesn't, instead of splitting onto the A site.
This is now becoming a slugfest here. One by one, Space Soldiers going down. That synergy we saw earlier is crumbling.
Yeah, it's a very similar circumstance to what we saw in the last
Where's
map.
The timeout?
That is a good point. How many do they have? What? Four?
Yeah. I mean, they should have taken a timeout after the loss of that. Let's say after the loss of the eco, maybe not then, but then, like, after the loss of the follow-up.
Okay, Neo.
Hello.
Doesn't even need his rifle. Just going to take them both down in style. And well, that's going to hurt your confidence a little bit, isn't it?
Yeah. Just goes deeper down the sewer.
Getting style points.
But, yeah. I mean, they should have definitely at least... latest after losing the follow-up weapon round, I should have taken a timeout just to at least take a breather, you know, cool things down, because they've not won a single round since.
Mm.
It's just the way it is.
And Major back to his trusty MAC-10. Gonna get himself a little bit of utility on the table behind it, at least.
It's like a rinse and repeat from map number one right now.
Yeah.
All we need is Space Soldiers win the second best round and then just get wrecked by a half-by.
Engin versus Bialy. The standoff. You must know he's there by now. He's been there so many times trying to take this challenge. Orp. Two orps still on the CT side. Actually, Engin with an SMG as well, so really not a great buy-in play at the moment, but they've done that just to be able to get some utility on the board. Santara's was very good starting off with the entry kills early in the half. Has gone a little bit quiet since then, and we can definitely tell the difference. 8-6 at the moment after what was an extremely good start. Was it 6-0 again?
It was 5-0, 5-1, 6-1, and that's when it all went to crap.
If anything, that's worse. Snacks is going to be getting one outside of re-peak from Despy. Well, you're not going to win that duel versus Snacks. Taz, well, he does a hell of a lot of damage, and Engin, he's down to 4 HP. They know exactly where he is. He's just going to have to dodge bullets at this stage. Does manage to peek out for a second. Oh, I think Snacks is going to be. He is. He's just waiting.
I dare you. Come out the window.
Pasha going to finish him off, and that will be it. 9-6 after
being.
After that start, that is insane. Yeah. That's absolute madness. And Virtus Pro.
6-1 up.
If you're Virtus Pro at this stage, you have to be laughing that you managed to get 9 rounds out of that half.
Nah, you just feel happy. You're not going to laugh. That's not nice. That's disrespectful.
Okay.
To your peers.
Okay, well, I'm sure. I don't know how close their booths are. I mean, they might not even be able to hear it.
But yeah, you could definitely say or tell and the lore towards the tail end of that half. Space Soldiers just crumbled. I mean, a lot of the things they were doing right, playing together well, just attacking together, making sure when they were splitting a bomb site that they'd be coming in together to make sure that it's super hard for CTs to find themselves in a good position. Instead, now they were just going in one by one, making it way too easy for players like Snacks and Taz to pick up kills there.
Mm. And even one of, like, they were very successful at taking outside a lot of the time, and even just some basic, some mistakes coming in that just allowed Virtus Pro to come back. Nice start, though, by Zontaris. Will be able to get himself one, but they have lost ramp in the meantime. Paz going to go aggressive to try and get that man advantage back, but actually loses a lot of HP. Engin expecting some sort of rotation, and now they're starting to take an awful lot of damage. The same can be said for the T side, however. And the bomb has now gone down. Snacks will take down Zontaris in the meantime. Paz, not really anywhere near the action. I think he has heard Bialy. Going to be trying to flank the flanker, Despy. Managing to get one. Don't actually have a kit in play, so they really need to start making themselves move. Paz with one will give them the man advantage now as they try and come back in. But these passive positions, they've got to try and clear these out. Taz, he hits the shot, does exactly what is needed of him. Just baiting them in, and all three for Taz.
Beautiful.
Yeah, lovely stuff.
Wow. Well, again, we had a T site going through ramps to a lower bomb site. And it works out great for them. It's a very hard bomb site to retake as well. There's so many corners, so many angles, so many possible crossfires there. And obviously, when you have an angry Taz in one of the corners,
yeah, you don't
ready
want
to take a 3K, well, that's pretty much the... That's the end of it. But now we got Space Soldiers with a force buy here. And Snacks keeps on buying these shotties.
I want to see where he's going. I want to see if we can get a Snacks cam.
I got you covered here. He's in the vents.
Yeah. See if he can do any damage with that weapon. Obviously, Space Soldiers trying to do what VP did to them in the previous map. Just get themselves rolling. Try and win this second round. Neo will actually be spotted. Obviously, this 5-7 needs a shot to the face. Actually, quick rotation from Major does a lot of damage as well. A couple of low players on the VP side. Snacks does manage to get one with the Sawn-off. And now it's Engin. Gets himself the first. Sawn-off still in play. The remaining players actually have the rifles. Snacks, how does he get away with that? Despy tagging him so very low and even manages to escape Engin on the way out. Engin now versus three, but two of them very, very low. And while Neo... Not even going to give him a chance to try and clutch that round out. Head taken clean off.
Did you just see that the solid teamwork from VP there in lobby? Like the way they help each other, you know. There's a guy just came out of hot. You know, they took that fight together. And then there was a guy pushing ramp who got one kill. But then there's a guy coming from the entry to lobby helping the third guy out. So like, there was so much synergy there with yeah. the players, making sure that none of them would have to take fights alone, make sure that you know nothing funny would happen in terms of the round just turning around because of them not playing together. So, a great example. Awesome synergy! As we have some very interesting situations going on here.
Nice try. They will actually... Okay, whoa. Major. Nice couple of kills. They picked up two AKs off the back of this. Yeah, and they've got the bomb. However, Pash is going to pick up one of them. Major bringing this back to a 2 versus 1. He's already got 3 kills in this round. Snacks with the sawn-off shotgun versus a no-armored player. What is that? Oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
22-8 at the moment.
Snacks. You beast.
500,000 damage. It just
he's such a troll. I mean, I saw him in the cafeteria or the catering earlier after they lost to Kingwin. He literally looks at me with a smirk in his face. We need to make Poland stronger. I'm like, okay, dude. Obviously, he's kidding. But just like the way he said it to me, I was like, okay, fair enough.
Asha, spray back through the smoke. We'll start things off onto Major. Not the start that Space Soldiers needed going into the first fire round of the second half. Now they're going to be fighting from behind. And, well, VP, this is not the situation you want to give over to VP. They're just going to take things nice and slow. Don't really need to go for anything crazy. I'm going to try and bait out any more aggression. Throwing quite a lot of utility. And, well, Taz is actually going to get the second kill of the round onto Zontaras as well. Execute beginning. Over towards this A site. Paz, he doesn't even have any armor in this round. He's gone for a no armor M4 with a few nades. And it doesn't look like the CTs have any clue about what's going on at the moment.
Yeah. They are literally getting sandwiched right now from Hot and from Heaven. So that's pretty much everywhere, including a main. So that's going to be Engine now alone in a 1-on-5. Poor old Engine. In an awkward situation. Ooh. Let's get the kill, but it's down to 19 HP. Well, dead now, of course.
Yeah. Ended by Pasha. And this is... Wow, this is ridiculous.
Yeah, this is beyond repair at this point in time, almost. Again, it's almost a rinse and repeat from that first map. Unfortunately, I mean, Space Soldiers were looking so good in
the early
parts of the map. Like, they were looking so on point. Their aim was on point. The way they were playing together was on point. Everything. And then one round. And it's just crumbled.
Sawn-off versus Mag-7. Battle of the shotguns. Zontaras, well,
down and out.
Yep, this is just ridiculous cleanup at this stage. Every player dying. Only about 40 seconds into the round, very, very quickly done, and not leaving just Major left. Snacks trying to take the long range battle with the sword off. We'll actually lose that one. I mean, it's surprised.
It's close to being BM at this point. Just holding on to it. You're playing for $200,000, brother. Come on.
I genuinely thought Taz was going back to pick that up for a second. He's got $8,700 with a post-buy, so I think Snacks is going to be all right. Paz will, in fact, keep the Mag-7 in play. Orp finally onto Despy as well, so at least going to have a different avenue to their defense. But 14-6, they're going to have to pretty much do exactly what they did to iGame and just string a ridiculous amount of rounds together.
That's pretty much it, isn't it? Mortis Pro going for a default, just throwing a smoke. I think Snacks might be trying to get into the vent before he does... with a Molotov though, so he's not gonna be able to run through that. Major is gonna get bombed by
nice
the radio.
Flash. And he manages to get one though, and that's gonna be the quick trade back. Nade could do a decent amount of damage. Doesn't actually get anyone, I don't think. And Bialy just gonna go pushing through the smoke. Zontaras is down. Engine trying to do what he can, but he'll fall as well to the entry man of Bialy. Does end up being taken down by the AWP. But still, it's gonna be this 3 versus 2. Paz. Ooh, can he do anything with this Mag-7 from here? Obviously, opening the door is going to be a bit of a giveaway. He's trying to spam through the smoke at range. Well, he's going to need a huge amount of luck to actually get that kill off. And our player in the vents knows exactly where he is. Does a bit of damage to Neo. Actually going to switch over to the Deeg, but doesn't even get a chance. Despy managing to pick up a rifle. Has got a lot of damage onto Taz. Almost manages to find him through the wall as well. 74 HP.
Yeah, both players low, but he doesn't have a kit. Wonder if there's one to be found somewhere on the floor. I think actually mollied off the vent as well, and he's just going to have to fade out of this round. Seemed like it, there was a possibility for him there, but just unable to do so. And yeah, that is ridiculous. What's that? 15? No, 14 rounds in a row. They've only won one other round.
Yeah, 14 rounds, yeah.
Well, that's VP for you.
15-6. From 6-1.
I'm actually six, in shock. Like, this is absolute madness from Virtus Pro. Just gone absolutely insane.
Enough with the shenanigans.
Hmm.
So there's Virtus Pro.
Best speed to start things off. Our middle snacks very quick. Bring this back. Sontara's with a decent position. Actually drops the bomb as well. Smoke will fall in. Snacks. Oh, it's going to be Taz actually from behind to catch him out. Paz manages one. Almost traded out by Snacks, doing a lot of damage onto Paz. 6 HP. Engine has an awful lot of utility to play with, but just going to be playing the close angle. Snacks seems to be clearing a lot. Still manages to win the duel. 2v2. Paz will be able to retrieve himself an AK at least, so something to play with. Looking to hold the angle and actually will win the duel. Now it's down to Bialy. He's spotted one player, knows exactly where the second is. Although dropping into vents, I'm liking this from Bialy, just trying to play the sneaky play. There's no way they could expect him to be up here. Don't think he knows that the player actually jumped out of hut though, but oh, he's going to go jumping back in. That Molotov will be well placed. Unfortunately, it's going to give his position away. And now, well, the CTs are going to know exactly where he is instead.
Yep, well, 35 on the clock. He needs to go retrieve the bomb, but there's a player right now making his way towards Secret and Major. He's going to be in hut. He's going to take this fight. Bialy gets it, though. And now look at the HP on Paz. Only 6.
Yeah, back into the 1v1. Obviously, Bialy doesn't have a clue where he is. 19 seconds left on the clock. He's going to be checking heaven as he goes for the bomb plant. It is looking like this may just be over, but Paz going to be trying to hold, just hoping that he'll walk into the crosshair. There is actually potential for it. Misses the shot. Now Bialy knows exactly where he is, and well, why not end it with a headshot as well? 16-6. 15 rounds in a row for Virtus Pro. What did I just witness? That came off one round. One mistake is enough for Virtus Pro just to completely destroy Space Soldiers. One mistake.
Yeah, I mean, kudos to Space Soldiers, you know, coming fourth in this tournament. First of all, I mean, we were expecting them to probably get up there amongst the semifinalists. But, yeah, a bit of a schooling there towards the end of it by Virtus Pro. I mean, initial parts of this map, Space Soldiers really looked good. Like, they seemed like they had their pacing on point. You know, they had a lot of depth into their playbook. The way they were playing individually and off of each other looked really good. But then it just all crumbled off of one round, and that's very concerning. Unfortunate,
well, you could say. It is unfortunate. Obviously, they did very well against Envy as well. I think that's probably going to be the most painful factor. Like, this game was...
They should have won map number 2.
Yeah.
And they were definitely winning map number 3 on that one.
So that I think that's going to be the thing they have to go back and look over. Either way, we only have one more game to go. It is going to be the grand final coming up shortly. Make sure you don't miss that one. We'll see you after the break. Going to go aggressive to try and get that man advantage back, but actually loses a lot of HP. Engine expecting some sort of rotation, and now they're starting to take an awful lot of damage. The same can be said for the T side, however. And the bomb has now gone down. Snacks will take down Zontaras in the meantime. Paz, not really anywhere near the action. I think he has heard Bialy. Going to be trying to flank the flanker. Despi managing to get one. Don't actually have a kit in play, so they really need to start making themselves move. Paz with one will give them the man advantage now as they try and come back in, but these passive positions, they've got to try and clear these out. Taz, he hits the shot, does exactly what is needed of him, just baiting them in, and all 3 for Taz.
Beautiful.
Yeah, lovely stuff.
Wow. Well, again, we had a T site going through ramps to a lower bomb site, and it works out great for them. It's a very hard bomb site to retake as well. So many corners, so many angles, so many possible crossfires there. And obviously, when you have an angry Taz in one of the corners,
yeah, you don't
ready
want
to take a 3K, well, that's pretty much the end of it. But now we've got Space Soldiers with a force buy here. And Snacks keeps on buying these shotties.
I want to see where he's going. I want to see if we can get a snacks cam.
I got you covered here. He's in the vents.
Yeah. See if he can do any damage with that weapon. Obviously, Space Soldier just trying to do what VP did to them in the previous map. Just get themselves rolling. Try and win this second round. Neo will actually be spotted. Obviously, it's 5-7. He needs a shot to the face. Actually, quick rotation from Major does a lot of damage as well. A couple of low players on the VP side. Snacks does manage to get one with the Sawn-off. And now his Engine gets himself the first. Sawn-off still in play. The remaining players actually have the rifles. Snacks, how does he get away with that? Despy tagging him so very low and even manages to escape Engine on the way out. Engine now versus three, but two of them very, very low. And while Neo, not even going to give him a chance to try and clutch that round out. Head taken clean off.
Did you just see that the solid teamwork from VP there in lobby? Like the way they help each other, you know, there's a guy just came out of hot, you know, they took that fight together, and then there was a guy pushing ramp who got one kill, but then there's a guy coming from the entry to the lobby helping the third guy out. So like there was so much synergy there with the players, making sure that none of them would have to take fights alone, make sure that, you know, nothing funny would happen in terms of the round just turning around because of them not playing together. So great example. Awesome synergy. As we have some very interesting situations going on here.
Nice try. They will actually... Okay, whoa. Major. Nice couple of kills. They picked up two AKs off the back of this. Yeah, and they've got the bomb. However, Pash is going to pick up one of them. Major bringing this back to a 2-1. He's already got three kills in this round. Snacks with the sawn-off shotgun versus a no-armored player. What is that? Oh my god.
Oh my god.
22-8 at the moment.
Snacks. You beast.
500,000 damage. It just
he's such a troll. I mean, I saw him in the cafeteria or the catering earlier after they lost to Kingwin. He literally looks at me with a smirk in his face. We need to make Poland stronger. I'm like, okay, dude. Obviously, he's kidding. But just like the way he said it to me, I was like, okay. Fair enough.
Asha, spray back through the smoke. We'll start things off onto Major. Not the start that Space Soldiers needed going into the first fire round of the second half. Now they're going to be fighting from behind. And, well, VP... This is not the situation you want to give over to VP. They're just going to take things nice and slow. Don't really need to go for anything crazy. I'm going to try and bait out any more aggression. Throwing quite a lot of utility. And, well, Taz is actually going to get the second kill of the round onto Zontaras as well. Execute beginning over towards this A site. Paz, he doesn't even have any armor in this round. He's gone for a no-armor M4 with a few nades. And it doesn't look like the CTs have any clue about what's going on at the moment.
Yeah. They are literally getting sandwiched right now from hot and from heaven. So that's pretty much everywhere, including a main. So that's going to be Engine now alone in a 1-on-5. Poor old Engine. In an awkward situation. Ooh. Let's get the kill, but it's down to 19 HP. Well, dead now, of course.
Yeah. Ended by Pasha. And this is... Wow, this is ridiculous.
Yeah, this is beyond repair at this point in time, almost. Again, it's almost a rinse and repeat from that first map. Unfortunately, I mean, Space Soldiers were looking so good in
the early
parts of the map. Like, they were looking so on point. Their aim was on point, the way they were playing together was on point, everything. And then one round, and it's just crumbled.
Sawn-off versus Mag 7. Battle of the shotguns. Zontaras, well,
down and out.
Yep, this is just ridiculous cleanup at this stage. Every player dying. Only about 40 seconds into the round. Very, very quickly done and not leaving just Major left. Snacks trying to take the long range battle with the sword off. We'll actually lose that one. I'm not overly surprised.
It's close to being BM at this point. Just holding on to it. You're playing for $200,000, brother. Come on.
I genuinely thought Taz was going back to pick that up for a second. He's got $8,700 with a post-buy. So I think Snacks is going to be all right. Paz will, in fact, keep the Mag 7 in play. Orp finally onto Despy as well, so at least going to have a different avenue to their defense. But 14-6, they're going to have to pretty much do exactly what they did to iGame and just string a ridiculous amount of rounds together.
That's pretty much it, isn't it? Mortis Pro going for a default, just throwing a smoke. I think Snax might be trying to get in the vent before he does whiff a Molotov, though, so he's not going to be able to run through that. Major is going to get ball flash in the radio.
And he manages to get one, though, and that's going to be the quick trade back. Nade could do a decent amount of damage. Doesn't actually get anyone, I don't think. And Bialy just going to go pushing through the smoke. Zantaras is down engine, trying to do what he can, but he'll fall as well to the entry man of Bialy. Disadvantage. Obviously, the economy on VP is not that great. You see Neo actually pulling in a mag 7. We'll be playing. Actually, he's outside at the moment. I think he was just using the stairs of secret as his sort of little mag 7 hidey hole, Bialy. He's going to fall over towards Hut. We'll give them a way back into this round. Snack's going to try and slow them down, but he doesn't actually decide to throw the Molotov. Taz coming in from upper as well. Zantaras, well, we know that he can be ready, and they're actually going to double molly him back, leaving them into a 3v4 with the bomb down. Time's starting to tick away, but they are running out, or run out pretty much, utility. They've only got one flashbang to play with. Zantaras, a lot of damage through the smoke, but it's actually Paz to find the kills. Zantaras doing a lot of damage at this point, and even finish off Pasha as well. One tap in the end, and Space Soldier just straight back into a winning streak.
In a 3-on-5 of all things as well. Basically, Engine getting that kill, opening a squeaky door, getting the kill on Bialy, who was on top of Hut, and that's basically the upper defense being nullified. And they get the bomb down, and then Zantaras once again showing up strong. A couple of kills, a lot of damage on the third guy as well. It made through smokes, and there you have it. It's going to be VP in struggle with their economy. They've been reset here.
6 rounds already on the T side.
Yeah, very, very good for Space Soldiers. Definitely showing some early strength here on Nuke.
Starting to get a little bit worrying for Vedaspar. Well, I think it's getting past a little bit worrying. Taz will be able to, however, find the first kill of the round. Very aggressive from him. Doesn't have that many bullets to play with in Zantaras. Well, he's not even going to give him the chance to find anything more. Despi down to 1 HP, however, does mean that there's still a lower player that could very easily fall to these pistols. Although, actually, he does go down. That is going to be an AK into the hands of Bialy. Pasha is going to spot Engine as well through the door, manages to finish him off. Not like this, Space Soldiers. After such a good round, to throw one away like this would be horrific. Major down to 35 HP. Zantara is the only player with any real health on the other side of things. The second AK has been picked up. Neo will, however, fall to Zantara's, and they have managed to get themselves the B site. Smoke will go down to allow them to plant the bomb, and the Molotov smartly placed to deny any quick rotations that can come in. Decent positioning, however, from Bialy could be the linchpin in this round. Manages to find one. Only Zantara's left. He's got a lot to do, and Snax is going to finish him off. Wonderful round from Virtus Pro, but Space Soldiers, well, they've thrown it away to pistols.
Yeah. They fall through in a moment where they were sitting on the driver's seat. Just pedal to the metal. Can't go forward, but instead, they're going to be losing that one there. Not really sure why Despi went for the outside catwalk there anymore, when you could tell VP was being, first of all, in a save situation and being very, very aggressive. So he still decided to go on outside catwalk. He had a CT there pushed up, goes down, and then kind of crumbles one by one from there on out.
And this has given a huge lifeline over Virtus Pro. They could have been in a double eco situation.
Yep, they
going into
been.
The next round. So yeah,
this is definitely, this could really change everything in terms of this first half, because I was going to say that it's very likely right now that Space Soldiers are going to be in the lead going into the halftime.
Mm. Yeah, cannot now disagree with that. They were so very close, but yeah, they've handed economy back over to Virtus Pro. 3 AKs picked up and off, been bought for Pasha. Major going to be caught. What? Snax almost finishing him off. 22 HP. Pasha has found another one in the meantime. Bialy actually shoots a little bit too early, but he should get one. Second Major actually going to win the duel, even with 22 HP.
Nice patience there from Major.
And Despi as well, jumping down. This should be the end of Tax, but... Tax? Snax? It's Taz and Snax combined.
That's their love child.
Oh, God. And you never pay tax. That's always the thing, isn't it?
Okay, then. Of course you do.
Of course, no. Engine is going to fall to Snax. I'll get his name right this time. And that will be
slight gap in the smoke there on yard. That's what had Major go down in HP so much. And Pialli doing a great job there in secret, buying a lot of time, getting that one kill. I feel like he should have had another one there, but Major with some dance moves gets the kill. But DP now sitting at 3, and an eco coming in from Space Soldiers.
Yeah, well, that's what happens when you lose a round to flat pistols. Your economy takes a massive hit. Had to force everything into the last, and they're coming back with very, very little. Virtus Pro really handed a huge opportunity. Flashbang will come out. They do know that Pash is going to have this AWP, but he's not going to miss that shot. Paz, he's going to fall to the Deagle as well. Pash yet to take a single point of damage. It looks like he may just be able to farm up some kills here. Despy coming in, but lovely one Deagle. Neo quickly to trade, so not too much of a problem. Obviously, every kill will help them at this stage. Virtus Pro, not with a huge amount of money in the bank. Taz is going to lose his life as well. Back to a 2v3. Bialy should be ready. They do actually have the bomb. If they can get this kill on Bialy, that would be a plan. But actually, crossfire in play. Snacks will get both. And a fourth on the board for VP.
Yeah, the AWP is being retrieved by Neo as well. So at least they had 3 survive that. So a bit of bank being made here for VP. And back to buying for Space Soldiers. Still no op for them. It's going to be all AKs. I mean, AWP on T-side of Nuke. This is definitely the last resort. So they don't seem desperate enough to have to go there yet. I mean, they've had a solid T-side so far. The only dent has to be the fact they lost to that eco. And that's what's giving Virtus Pro a chance. And I'm not sure you want to give those kind of chances to a team like Virtus Pro.
Oh, definitely not. Definitely not.
Seems like an Opera Execute is coming in from Space.
They're going to try the door thing again. Actually going to be the bomb dropped outside by Snacks. That's going to put a little bit of a dent in this plan. And Bialy, using the Tech 9, switching over to the AK, finds another as well. Triple Lovely. For him. And Zantara is now left. Well, this is a big problem. He knows that Snacks is somewhere outside. Obviously, well, actually, no. He's rotated all the way back in since he's got that kill.
This time, Bialy was ready for that squeaky door to open. This massive amount of damage. Dancing around of smoke. As Bialy is going to get that last kill on Santaris as well. And a clean sweep for Virtus Pro.
And now the money
time.
Is.
And now they're swimming in cash right now. And it's going to be another save.
Welcome back to the World Esports Game. That's a nice badge you got on.
Pretty pride colors.
Well, you need it, obviously, to get into the exclusive places that you get into, right?
I mean, I've actually forgotten this to the hotel a couple of days, and I just walking around. No one's asked anything.
That I have been able to do that for a bit, but I got a little bit scared by the riot guys on the door and decided I would get a new one. Didn't think it would be a very good idea. Obviously, enough of like what we're doing. It is map number 2, Nuke.
Yep.
Virtus Pro.
Home turf.
Yeah.
Home turf.
Do you see, are there any like win conditions, anything you can see that Space Soldiers can actually take this map and take it to 3?
Well, it's hard to see those, considering the fact that VP has shown extreme strength on Nuke. And, like, I didn't get to see the game. I heard that Space Soldiers had one heck of a CT side on Nuke against iGame. But then again, iGame, very different beast from VP. And I don't even know their pedigree on Nuke either. So I think it's very tough to see them win.
Well, I think, we saw VP versus Envy, right? And they were pretty consistent on that, so
yep.
I think it was only really Apex like having a couple of rounds that had any problems with their CT side whatsoever.
Yeah, I mean, there was a couple of rounds where Envy managed to execute towards Opera bomb site, one with pistols and one with full weaponry, where they managed to kind of sandwich that defense and make it uncomfortable for Virtus Pro. But other than that, Snacks is so good on yard. For example, Aneo compliments helping him from heaven and from hell with an op. And then Snacks just lurking around the smokes and just getting so many kills.
Just doing Snacks things
when the T's are trying to take over yard, which is one of the go-to plans here on new T side. You kind of have to try to at least make it seem like you're taking over yard, and when you do that, Snacks is going to be heck of a problem.
I think also yesterday I quite enjoyed Pasha over towards ramp, just doing the job very consistently. I think. People, I like watching Magisk over on that position as well, like very, very good over towards
this is also the home turf of Taz. Being throughout times, he's so good on Nuke usually.
Yeah, he was the star in that game versus Envy. Exactly. Absolutely brilliant. I think he was playing by Hot, if I'm correct.
Yeah, he plays upper. Almost, I think, pretty much always done that for the last 15 years.
Well, I suppose he's got pretty good at it in that amount of time.
Yeah, I mean, you should be able to find your comfort zone in that time. But it appears the VP is going to get to start on CT side. So definitely not going to be easy for Space Soldiers. Remember, Space Soldiers won both pistol rounds on Kabul, and they ended up with 8 rounds.
Oh yeah, well, and the pistol round was the only round they won on that T side. So.
Okay, let's look at this now. Space Soldiers are opting to go for 2 sets of nades. They have Major with a Technon armor as well. Seems like they are going in towards lobby and ramp right now.
Just going to try and get up close and personal to Pasha. Doing his best just to try and fade away, but it doesn't look like it's going to happen. Major will start things off with the first kill, and now we're going to see them drop towards that B site. But quick rotations will allow Neo to get himself a kill straight back in. They do, of course, have a kit ready for this B site, and they're just going to fade away, try and keep things easy. Major getting very close, but he's actually going to lose his life to Bialy. Bomb will go down within the smoke, and Zontara's again back to actually a 3v2, 3v1 even, as Paz gets another one, and now it's just Snacks. Doesn't have himself the kit. There is a kit somewhere on the map, but well, Zontara's just going to take his head clean off. And Space Soldiers with another pistol.
Yeah, that's 3 out of 3 so far for Space Soldiers in this best of 3, and that's a good. That's the kind of start they definitely need here on Nuke. And that was them just going over on ramp. Major as the raid boss, being the first guy in, getting the initial kill onto Pasha. He might have slightly overextended, going to the vents, trying to go into the back halls. I think he should have just maybe stayed in the vents and, you know, just play the afterplan from there. But eventually, his teammates did clean it up, and they do pick it up. And as we can see from VP side, they've done some investments here. There's 3 deagles, a CZ, and a scout in play.
And this time, Space Soldiers gonna go with a few rifles.
No upper rush. Kind of disappointed here.
I'm not gonna go for a hugely risky buy. Snacks is gonna be naded down to just 17 HP, so we'll have to fade away. Of course, with that deagle repositioning, just gonna hold an angle and try and get that one ball, which this weapon is so well known for. Scout outside on Neo hasn't really been able to spot anything too much. May have got the tag onto Zontaris, who is now down to 39 HP. And I like this from Snacks. He's going to try and use the door.
Yep.
Definitely.
Not taking their time. They have the utility to go lower bomb side. They can smoke off left or right side, Molotov the other side, on towards ramp, and then get the bomb plant.
Taz will be able to take down one of those AKs. Wonder if he's actually going to be able to retrieve it. Does have himself armor as well, which, well, that could be a bit of a game changer. I don't think he's really got the possibility, and actually Neo is going to fall in the meantime. The SMG is doing quite a lot of work in this round. In fact, Bialy is going to go pushing towards Zontaris, who is the one defending the AK. Taz able to take down a second, but much better this time from Space Soldiers, and they're not going to be able to retrieve one of the AKs.
Yep, very traditional anti-eco going yard, slowly just trying to feel out what the CZs are doing. VP not able to really utilize that scout from Neo at all. Snacks also being in secret, getting tagged down to very low HP very initially. That Space Soldier's just taking over the lower tunnels there towards the lower bomb site. And then eventually, with 3 alive, winning that round.
Snacks not going for any armor in the last means he is actually going to buy another deagle into this round. Apart from that, we've got one P250 on the board and absolutely nothing else on the Virtus Pro side. Major, well, he's looking to just have a field day at this point. He's got his MAC-10. He's been doing quite well with it so far. Actually had it in a couple of buy rounds versus Envy and still managed to pull off quite a bit of damage. So definitely someone who enjoys this weapon. Neo will be the first of all. Not really expecting too much, but Snacks is in a decent position to catch one. Nice shot onto Zontaris. Actually going to be a dink coming in onto Paz as well. They do have to be a little bit careful here, Space Soldiers. Don't really want to lose too much in this round. Major is going to give them back the man advantage once again. They are just
curious of Space Soldiers, and it's all tied up. Again, a massive lead. Just gone.
On one round. Like, you can pin nearly all of them.
This could have been easily at 8-2 before a Virtus Pro could have bought, unless they won that eco round.
Yeah, not good.
That's the consequence out of the fact that they lost that eco.
Pistols once again. Pasha is going to be ready and waiting to try and line up these players. They managed to take him down last time. Nade going to do so much damage already. Now he's just going to wait. They're actually going to throw it a second, but Zontaris does manage to get that kill.
Pasha not really having too much luck at the moment. Neo is still there. Will be tapping away. He's going to have to fall back in the end and give up a little bit of control, but he does have snacks to support, and, well, what more do you need?
Yep. Snacks almost at 16k at this point already. Well, full buy for Space Soldiers again. AK-47s. Well, utility be bought as well. I think the most they've really had is through their outside smokes and then sending a couple secret, taking over ramp, going lower bomb side. So they definitely do have depth into their play box. Let's see what they do. They're just gonna go dry on guard. Take a duel with Snacks, who's gonna get the first major equalizes before Pasha gets his own.
Yeah, Pasha actually now moving over to playing the outside position. SP. Oh, almost giving a kill over to Pasha, and actually does. He's fallen back. The aggressive push will come out from Taz, and he falls in the meantime, giving them a lifeline. But Pasha's just lining them up and knocking them down. Pixelated angles. Wow. And that was lovely from Pasha.
Yeah. I mean, that was him being moved from a ramp to outer bomb to yard. That's Virtus Pro basically having a feel. You know, Space Soldiers has done a lot of work through yard. So let's send our opera there to back Snacks up. And, well, it definitely worked this time. As it happened, Space Soldiers, for some reason, decided to run in there totally dry. No smokes or anything. That's very interesting.
Oh, Pasha's just going to say thank you very much.
Questionable, I would say.
Engine will actually purchase up an AWP of his own. Glass Cannon. Interested to see it come out on him. It is normally Despy with it in hand. So they're going to try and challenge outside. It is Snacks with another AWP this time. And, well, these orbs have started to make things much more difficult for Space Soldiers to actually get any presence on the map.
Yeah, well, now they're in desperation mode as Engine has that up. And they've already lost one man in Paz. But they have gotten a lot of map control. This Major is very close to main right now. I could potentially set up for a bit of a upper split, but as I say that, Snacks with an op is just going to nullify Major.
Yeah, he tries to go a little bit further around, instead of splitting onto the A site.
This is now becoming a slugfest here. One by one, Space Soldiers going down. That synergy we saw earlier is just crumbling.
Yeah, a very similar circumstance to what we saw in the last
map. Where's the timeout?
That is a good point. How many did they have? What? Four?
Yeah. I mean, they should have taken a timeout after the loss of that. Let's say after the loss of the eco, maybe not then, but then like after the loss of the follow-up.
What round? Okay, Neo.
Hello.
Doesn't even need his rifle. Just going to take them both down in style. And, well, that's going to hurt your confidence a little bit, isn't it?
Yeah. Just goes deeper down the sewer.
Getting style points.
But yeah, I mean, they should have definitely, at least latest after losing the follow-up weapon round, they should have taken a timeout. Just to at least take a breather, you know, cool things down, because they've not won a single round since.
Mm.
It's just the way it is.
And Major back to his trusty MAC-10. Going to get himself a little bit of utility on the table behind it, at least.
It's like a rinse and repeat from map number one right now.
Yeah.
All we need... Space Soldiers win the second best round and then just get wrecked by a half by.
Engine versus Bialy. The standoff. You must know he's there by now. He's been there so many times trying to take this challenge. Orp. Two orps still on the CT side. Actually, Engine with an SMG as well, so really not a great buy in play at the moment, but they've done that just to be able to get some utility on the board. Sontara's was very good starting off with the entry kills early in the half. Has gone a little bit quiet since then, and we can definitely tell the difference. 8-6 at the moment after what was an extremely good start. Was it 6-0 again?
It was 5-0, 5-1, 6-1, and that's when it all went to crap.
If anything, that's worse. Snacks is going to be getting one outside of re-peek from Despy. Well, you're not going to win that duel versus Snacks. Taz, well, he does a hell of a lot of damage, and Engine, he's down to 4 HP. They know exactly where he is. He's just going to have to dodge bullets at this stage. Does manage to peek out for a second. Oh, I thought Snacks is going to be... He is. He's just waiting.
I dare you. Come out the window.
Pasha going to finish him off, and that will be it. 9-6 after
being
After that start, that is insane. That's absolute madness. And Virtus Pro.
6-1 up.
Like a, well, you have to, if you're Virtus Pro at this stage, you have to be laughing that you managed to get 9 rounds out of that half.
Nah, you just feel happy. You're not going to laugh. That's not nice. That's disrespectful.
Okay.
To your peers.
Okay. Well, I'm sure. I don't know how close their booths are. I mean, they might not even be able to hear it.
But yeah, you could definitely say or tell that lore towards the tail end of that half. Space Soldiers just crumbled. I mean, a lot of the things they were doing right, playing together well, just attacking together, making sure when they were splitting a bomb site that they'd be coming in together to make sure that it's super hard for CTs to find themselves in a good position. Instead, now they were just going in one by one, making it way too easy for players like Snax and Taz to pick up kills there.
Mm. And even one of, like, they were very successful at taking outside a lot of the time, and even just some basic, some mistakes coming in that just allowed Virtus Pro to come back. Nice start, though, by Zontaris. Will be able to get himself one, but they have lost ramp in the meantime. Paz bringing that AK along with them. Don't want any opportunity for someone on Virtus Pro to grab that.
Yeah. Definitely try to avoid that and make sure Major manages to pick it up eventually if he stays alive. Snax contemplating on the idea of going down ladder. It's going to come down to timing for him if he manages to get down there. It's going to be all down to Snax now. Deagle in hand. Maneuvering around here, going towards hell.
Still an AK on the floor somewhere. Imagine it's probably in the worst possible position to him to try and get.
Yeah, lower bombs at somewhere, so. Yeah, there we go. It's already picked up.
And now, well, just going to wait for the exit. Try and find someone along the way. Despy, only with an SMG, so he's going to be the furthest forward, just clearing out angles. Don't want to risk an AK. Will actually lose his life. UMP, well, can actually be utilized, and any more kills from Snax here is more than he should get, and well, they are going to finish him off, so good work in the end from Space Soldiers. They keep all their weapons in play.
Yep.
And, well, now we go into the buy round.
Yeah, Major making its way down secret, and basically the rest of Space Soldiers taking over ramp, and then eventually making their way downstairs to the lower bomb site. And then, again, you have 3 surviving from them. So, at least that's some money being saved going far forward. And, as we can see, VP is not going to be able to get any ops in here in the first weapon round with the second round investment.
Do have a decent amount of utility, though.
Yep.
Especially considering the fourth
though.
Round. By, yeah, 1 kit onto Taz. Boost will be put into place. Normally good for at least 1 kill, but then coming around the corner, it is very difficult to defend that position without any other support. See, Neo is playing a position where he could get back there, but definitely not going to be the easiest case scenario. Smokes going to be laid down outside. As you said previously, this can just be used for the illusion of pushing out, but we are actually going to see Major going along. Paz will be spotted for it by Snax, and don't think there's really anything he can do about these players crossing over.
Yeah, bomb is down in lobby, though, so that might be an idea for us that it could still be like an upper split coming in. People try to get into the vents and then creep up from them. And basically coming through squeaky and hot. And now Fall Flush comes in and Zontaris gets that first kill into Pasha. This does pass on to Snax.
Yeah, no, that really shouldn't have happened. That position is very, very strong for getting the first player running around the corner. Well, Zontaris was just too good. It will be the trade eventually, but still the man advantage sat with Space Soldiers. If they can get themselves a 5-0 start on Nuke, well, that could be a completely different story. However, Neo is actually going to drop one and the bomb.
Yeah, low HP on Paz, and now Despy as well, even though he does get a kill on the Taz. So, still all to do for here for Bialy and Neo. The bomb is down too, so.
Oh, is he going to hear them? He's definitely going to hear them. Doesn't manage to connect the first shots. Flashbang comes in and Paz peeks while it pops. Nothing Neo can do in that situation. Now Bialy, well, the one thing on his side is the time. 14 seconds left. Doesn't manage to connect the spray onto Major. And it will be a fourth round in a row now for Space Soldiers. Similar start to the previous map.
Yeah. Solid job from Xantharis getting that pick on ramp. I mean, either he expected there to be boost up there, or he was so up close somewhere in radio that he heard them boost up there. Those are 2 options, basically. Well, he got the first kill, and then Paz also converting for another one. 5-on-3. Neo then for the bit of a flank from ramp. That's where the bomb dropped in lobby, but solid job again from Space Soldiers to be able to pick up that bomb once again with a bit of teamwork there. With the Paul Flash coming in, taking out Neo. Pialino 103 in the end. And again, it's going to be outside smokes coming in here for Space Soldiers. About the bomb down again towards lobby, so just two guys committing their way towards secret.
Snacks. First of all, manages to do a little bit of damage, but not anything too crazy. And it is looking like this outer push is something Space Soldiers quite enjoy. It's going to be taking this battle again. Well, especially in these anti-eco rounds, they just take it straight down and just try and push around. Obviously, taking a lot of map control. Bomb yet to move as of yet. Well, picking against this scout is a little bit risky, though. Don't really know why they're still doing it. Neo may be able to take a couple major eventually trades, and they will take him down and win the round.
Yep. Again, outside smokes from Space Soldiers, sending three up there. DSP on top of the roof.
Ooh, double up.
Then he had to go through towards Secret. And yeah, just slowly trying to gain map control and making sure they're playing together, playing off of each other. In case one of you falls, you'll have a teammate to trade the kill straight from the get-go. And they do survive with four alive, so that's a very solid anti-eco. And as you pointed out, VP has gone for double ops, but it's going to be an up rush coming in.
This could be the worst case scenario. Taz, you've got a hell of a lot to do, but he's got support from Bialy. First kill goes, but Zontaras with two entries onto the site leaves it into a 3v3. Taz is going to maneuver himself between the silos, but he's actually going to get his life lost to Major. Snacks with one back and actually spraying through the smoke. Manages to catch Despy quite heavily down to 41 HP. Pasha as well rotating in will drop the bomb. And now Despy is left alone. Taz really buying a lot of time there for his team to rotate in. But it's still Despy versus two. Now he had a decent start to the map. Was one of the players that actually got them a couple of rounds after those initial five. Normally with that AWP, will manage to retrieve the bomb. Obviously still got Pasha in upper, and the second he tries to plant this bomb, it should be lights out. Got 55 seconds to play with, though. Does not have to rush at all. But the big problem is Snacks. It's just going to be sneaking around behind him. Any noise made, and, well, Snacks is just going to finish him off. Actually trying to get towards Pasha here. This could work quite nicely. He's managed to do it very, very silently, but Pasha catches him in the end.
Yeah, he does, and that was just Despy basically trying to isolate into two individual one-on-ones. Mm. That's the whole idea he was there having there. And yeah, I mean, that upper rush pretty much was the best possibility they had against double ops. Obviously, not knowing there was double ops, but I still do like the idea. And I think, you know, solid job from Taz, for example, just stay alive as long as he did, you know, getting a couple kills there along the lines. And then obviously that Snacks in main, he gets the guy that jumps in through the smoke into main. That creates the 2-on-2. So very close again. Space Soldiers managing to get that 5-0 lead. Is it going to be a similar story as Pasha starts off with two great kills here?
Yeah, making things very difficult. I don't see the T's pushing this anymore. It just doesn't really seem worth it. Actually going to go for the pot flash, but I think that was just trying to get them out of position. Now, the T's with a two-man.